Good to see you.
Hello, guys. Thanks for having me this morning.
Are you ready for a brand new season?
I'm ready. I've just gone into a little bit of a food detox, but I'm ready. You know, it's funny because we filmed that in January, and I have to keep quiet about it until it airs. And so I've been going to the gym and getting my figure back. And just when I'm going to get my figure back, I have to probably go back to work and gain weight and eat again and stuff. So
yeah, because the kind of food that they make on your show is not, you know, carrot sticks and celery.
No, because they want to win, right? Yeah. So they're putting whatever they can to make it juicy and yummy and taste good. Uh-huh. I mean, you don't always have to add fat and all that stuff to make things taste good, but... You know, they want to win. They don't care about my waistline at all, which they shouldn't.
You know, I told my wife about the guest list from yesterday. We had the presidential candidate. We've had senators. We've had congresspeople. We've had everyone top to bottom. When I told my wife that you were going to be on, she's like, oh, my, can you talk to her? Can you get her on? Are you surprised about the success of cooking shows?
You know, I am and I'm not. I mean, we're very proud of the show. And, right. And you know, we have great producers who come up with these challenges season after season. But I think everybody's so interested in food. You don't have to be a food professional to have really strong opinions about food. Every creature on the planet eats, you know?
Does everyone remember the first time they cleaned their palate? Until that cookie show, going, how about if we had a palate and it's got to be cleansed?
Oh, my gosh.
And sure, it's the best thing. Who would have thought?
It is. It's just, you know, we probably do it drinking water between, you know, bites of food or a cup of coffee before dessert or whatever. But, yeah, who knew what an amuse-bouche was? You know, I get...
A what?
I get little teenagers or preteens coming up to me and saying, we had a Top Chef quickfire party last night at my house, and we competed for the best amuse-bouche. And amuse-bouche is something to amuse your palate or bouche, your mouth. And it's just a little one-bite teaser that gives you a taste of what the chef has in store for you.
It's a new pickup line.
Yeah.
How's your amuse-bouche?
It sounds very dirty, right?
Amuse
your bouche.
So if you see Padma on the mall and you want to make time with her, there you go. You use the bouche line. She loves it. Hey, tell me about something that Eric always asked me in the breaks. What are the new trends with culinary?
In food? Yes. Sure. Well, you know, everything old is new again. So all these regional specialties, you know, whether it's Appalachian barbecue rub or Southern Carolina barbecue, that is big. And also this idea of savory and sweet together. Mm. Like if you take our show, for example, you know, in that Sesame Street episode, Dale Talday, you know, made these compost cookies. Or no, that's David Chang. David Chang's a chef here. He makes compost cookies with everything from, you know, coffee grinds to peanuts to pretzels. Right. And then Dale, on our show for the cookie challenge, he made cookies with crushed potato chips in them. You know, so, or Mario Batali will have salt.
So you don't even bother trying to be healthy and staying, you know, fit, the salt, the butter,
well,
the cheeses.
Well, everything in moderation. For instance, you know, we have this thing with Frito-Lay. 2 months ago, they announced, for example, that they were going to take 50% of their product portfolio, and they were going to make those products with all natural ingredients. They were committed to doing this by the end of the year. And I was very skeptical of this, you know. Really, really a big packaged food company is going to do this, potato chips, but they really are. Not every potato chip is created equal. You know, there's still potato chips, but all the Lay's, all the Tostitos, all the Sun chips are, by the end of the year, going to be all natural.
All right, so do they taste the same?
They do because I was very skeptical and they sent me a bunch. Right. I have some here. I know it's early in the morning, but I'm used to eating all kinds of weird food at all times of weird times.
These guys need some energy.
You guys want
to
try
it? They're about to go on a fish.
Yeah. They're yummy. They're yummy. These are, for instance, this is another food chip.
That's potato, right?
Yeah, this is a potato chip. This is a Lay's chip. And it's a creamy Mediterranean. Well, so it's taking that kind of sour cream and onion, but going very gourmet with it.
See, if someone tells me I'm going to go natural with potato chips, it makes sense because you grow potatoes. But
where
are the Frito trees and the cheese doodle bushes? How do you get
I
them
can't
natural?
Speak about all that. You know, I can tell you what I know, which is about, you know, Tostitos and Lay's and Sun chips. Those are the chips that I love. Those are the chips that I did my research on because, you know, I was really wondering about the truth of this, and it's true. And they've also, you know, made a contribution to a women's health charity, which I'm a co-founder of, called the EFA. So they've really put their money where their mouth is. And so I thought they they deserved. They merited some publicity, and that's why I'm happy to talk about it with great sincerity.
Right.
Well, and, you know, so they're also very aware of these food trends because they have a flavor kitchen in Texas, and that's what they do. They watch our show or they read best-selling cookbooks. They take real dishes, and they adapt those flavors onto chips because that's what we're all thinking about when we go out, and that's what we want at home, too.
And no wonder you're such a successful host. You make Ryan Seacrest look awkward. You are a fantastic host. What a personality you are.
Thank you. I'm very flattered. If only I had Ryan's paycheck, but, you know, right. Then again, I'm young.
Soon. Padma's idols.
That's right.
Enough for me.
Yes,
I'm signing
exactly.
up.
Exactly.
All right, great to meet you. Continued
nice
success.
Nice to meet you guys. Thank you so much for having me on, and thanks
and
for
nice
watching
meeting.
This show.
Okay. We have the Deadliest Catch guys outside if you want to come out.
Okay, sounds
right?
great.
That's
great.
That's not asking you out. I'm just giving you an opportunity to come out later.
Thank you. At least we don't have to do a clarification later.
We do. We always do.
Okay.